Today, guys, we are continuing our journey on the NC500. We're going from Tung to Lochinver. So join us on this epic journey. Everything is freaking beautiful. Everything.
View after view after view.
Yeah. Hello.
We're going in.
When we wake, hear the birds and see the sun. Side by side, our fears are done.
So guys, this is what tongue likes, man. For a place that's named after one of the largest muscles in the body in your mouth, this is a really beautiful place. I can't recommend coming here enough to you. It is so nice. We stayed at a little car park. It's a little car park in a hotel, bought a couple of drinks, cost us about £9 for the two free drinks. And we had a lovely stay. Tung, it's just off the north coast, northwest coast of Scotland. And this is what you get if you stay here. Mountains, beaches, beauty. It is awesome. We're on day, can't even remember now. That's how much fun we're having. It's so amazing. But today we're going from, Tung, by the way, what an amazing stop. Thoroughly recommend that. All around that area, it's beautiful. And then now we're sort of going, teetering from north to northwest, sort of going along the west bit, going in and out of all these beautiful mountains on these amazing roads, these twisty, windy roads. And yeah, the scenery changes. Believe it or not, everyone just thinks Scotland is Scotland sort of thing. The scenery is changing by the turn as well. You know, it really is. You might go to some alpine bits, to some desolate flat bits, to some huge, stark, pointy mountains with snow on top, which you just saw back there. Absolutely amazing.
Wow, talking about turning corners and seeing different scenery, we've just gone over this like hill and the scenery here is just something else. Everyone is pulling over because everyone wants a photo. It's absolutely stunning.
Just check this out. How amazing is this view? It's just incredible.
So we're driving through literally the most stunning scenery ever. It's so gorgeous. And we are trying to find somewhere that we can stop amongst all this scenery so we can have breakfast, because we haven't had breakfast yet. So there's a few places to sort of passing lanes and stuff like that. So we're trying to find something substantial that we can, you know, really pull over, have a cup of coffee and have a really gorgeous view in front of us for breakfast. Okay, so as you can see, we've found the most idyllic breakfast spot and we're gonna head over to the beach and just have a look at it first, and we might take some snacks down there as well actually.
Welcome to the Caribbean of Scotland.
Okay, it's so sunny here, but it's still blooming freezing, oh my God.
If it wasn't so bloody freezing, it would be a friggin' postcard.
I reckon people would surf there. They're like proper rips. So nice. So cold. I am not paddling. So we've decided that this is actually our breakfast spot for today. We're having some graze items. This isn't an ad, by the way, but. So it literally started raining just as we were coming off the beach. We were really lucky to catch a bit of sun on there, actually. And now we've decided, because we had snacks on the beach, we're not really hungry anymore, but we have heard that there's a place where you can get a hot chocolate really close by, so we're going to go there instead. We've just seen signs to a cave, so we're going to pop in there before the hot chocolate.
Okay, so we're not actually at the hot chocolate place just yet. There was a little stopover beforehand called Smoo Cave. Someone else recommended us to come and have a look at it, at least.
So this is the way down to Smoo Cave. It's quite a distance. Okay, I wasn't actually expecting the cave to be this big, but it's massive. It's really big.
So that's Smoo Cave on the west coast, northwest coast. Nice and everything, really nice, beautiful cave. You can pay to do more, so £10 for a guided tour and you go further in. But, you know, you don't need to. It's just nice to look at. It's a beautiful beach, it's a beautiful cave. And we need to keep moving. Out we go from Smoo. And we're off to see if we can get Janine a mochaccino. She doesn't fancy a hot chocolate, she fancies a mochaccino.
Okay, you literally, on this side of Scotland, you literally go about 5 minutes before you feel like you need to stop and take a photo. So we've just left the touristic caves to come to an award-winning beach, literally 5 minutes down the road. And we're gonna take a snap and then head on our way for some hot chocolate. We will get there. Beach an award, Liam?
Actually, yeah, I would.
Would you?
Yeah, a big fat award.
A big fat juicy award.
Oh, totally, it's absolutely stunning. So we're just going to get hot chocolate now, but you know that beach that you just saw there, that incredible beach, was called Sango Sands Campsite. It was the nicest beach, one of the nicest beaches I've ever seen in the UK. It was incredible. So remember that, Sango Sands, amazing. If we could come back, I'd spend a week there. No worries.
So we're back in the van after that beautiful beach spot, and we only need to go 1 minute down the road to get to this hot chocolate place. A mountain mocha.
Yeah, can we get two mountain mochas with oat milk, please?
And a vegan or non-vegan?
Both vegan, please. Have you got any vegan cakes or anything? Vegan croissants normally here, which would have been brilliant. We've done a little video on that. And vegan dark chocolate truffles as well. But most importantly, they've got vegan mocha.
So it's got vegan chocolate in it as well as oat milk. So it's like a proper hot chocolate or a proper mocha.
Okay, we're at a bit of a point where we want to go and get our phone camera battery charger from Ullapool. You've got no idea when you look at the map how big the place is, how long it's going to take to get somewhere, what's going to be along the way, more to the point. Are we going to miss anything if we go too quick? Are we going to miss anything if we go too slow? And that's part of what's going round my head constantly. Everything is freaking beautiful. Everything is beautiful. The beaches are beautiful. The mountains are beautiful. You could stop and spend weeks at each place and just soaking it up. But we've got a time frame. We've got a bigger time frame than most people, but we've still got a time frame. So Ginny and I were just trying to work out what we're going to do. And we're just going to keep going, see a lovely sight, spend a bit of time there, try and soak it up as much as possible. But have in the back of our minds, we want to see as much as possible as well. If there's something nice, we're going to stop. If it's ridiculously nice, we'll probably stop the night. Otherwise, we're going to keep going to Ullapool, which is where our battery charger is. Yes, man. Hooligan. Anyone else love to do that? get in a kit car and drive all around the NC500.
Okay, so we've had our coffee this morning. We're just trying to find somewhere now that we can eat, somewhere we can pull over and have a nice drink and something to eat. So we're on a mission now to find that perfect place.
Little bowl of brunch.
Yeah.
With some fruit.
Yeah.
Some mango with some berries. This is Janine who says this. To save using up all the lovely granola, we've got all organic. All of this stuff is lovely and inorganic. But to save using up the granola, you put a bit of rolled oats on the bottom, a bit of Scottish oats on the bottom, like this. And then, where's the...
There's two jars of
the
granola.
Sacred granola. We've got two jars of it, if it's still sacred. This is proper nice, really nice vegan, organic vegan granola here.
Oh, you're pouring it everywhere.
You are. Hold on. It's because it's so good. There we go, get a bit of the old granola in there. And then we put a bit, what, I learned all of this from Janine actually. Then you put a bit of milk in. This is where you put a bit of milk in. Just to make it all moist on the bottom, a little bit moist, those oats. You don't want to be chewing on oats, but you don't mind chewing on granola. Then we load it up with a bit of a high protein Alpro yogurt.
Lovely cutlery holder.
It is really nice, it's actually very practical.
It's really saved us.
Yeah, a bit of the old, oh wow, this is like Greek yogurt.
Oh, that is
proper
nice.
Thick. This is high protein Alpro. Oh, we've had this before, but just in smaller pots.
Oh.
And we put a dollop of that on.
And then what?
Little spoon. Listen, I'm not done yet. Then.
Don't we have some dates?
Yeah, now listen, just leave it with me. Then it's fruit time. This is frozen fruit that we defrosted just at the beach back there. This is mango and strawberries and all of that. You're going to have berries every day, some form of berries every day. To keep you healthy, says Dr. Gregor. Okay, then that, and then look, we're not done yet. We're not done. This is when we go for chopped date territory.
Wow, this is turning into really.
These are organic chopped dried dates. I'm not even done yet. Can we get some cashews? Organic cashews. Sprinkle them. Sprinkle. And then you think we're finished. Don't you? You think we're finished? Not now, not yet. Desiccated coconut. Just a little bit. Just gives a little, it just so goes so well with those cashews.
Wow.
You think we're done now, don't you?
Yeah.
Even now you think we're done, we're not.
What's next?
We've got hold of this very exclusive oat syrup. I bet you've never tried oat syrup before because it's brand spanking new. Guess what? We've never tried oat syrup before, but we're in Scotland. Scotland's famous for oats. And do you know what? We're gonna give it a go. Here we go. Oh, look at that. It's quite nice, isn't it? See, it sort of comes out like.
It does actually. It's got like.
It's got caramel.
It's like more like honey, isn't it?
Yeah.
As opposed to maple syrup.
So that's oat syrup, look.
Oat syrup.
Organic oat syrup. Sweet and mild.
Cool.
And yeah, let's just go do a quick taste test of that. I've never tried it before. Oat syrup. Wow. It tastes like essence of porridge. It tastes like essence.
Does it really?
It tastes, Do you want a bit of your finger, Janine?
Yeah. Oh, okay.
It's really, yeah, it's not really sweet. Yeah, so what do you think?
Essence of porridge, you say?
Essence of porridge. See what do you think?
Porridge essence.
We're getting distracted. Here we go. This is what we've got going on. We're going to go and enjoy these now. Don't they look great?
They look awesome.
This is our Scottish brunch, except that it's 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Let's go and enjoy it with a view. Thank you. want to know where we're at and what this epic route today has probably been the most outstanding part of the journey so far. This has been between the town of Tongue and, so far, Loch Inver. What's this? Is it a goat? It's a massive goat.
Aww. It's a wild goat.
Oh, watch out.
In the middle of the road. Oh my God, how cute. Hello. Just another day in Scotland.
He's got an awesome beard, hasn't he?
Yeah.
He's coming up to the window, look. Hey, yeah.
Hello.
Hello. What have we got here? Hello.
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 Oh my God.
Hey. Hello, come on, it's okay.
Hello, you. What are you doing?
Is somebody like looking for a goat? This is like the village goat. Anyone missing a goat? Anyway, okay, so sorry, I was rudely interrupted by a giant goat. I don't know what that was all about. But yeah, if you want to know where this epic route has been today, it's been between Tongue and Tongue and Loch Inver, and we actually might be going to Ullapool. We don't know yet. We don't know where we are, but that's the route. It's on the northwest of Scotland, and it's where you've got scenery like this with these islands.
Actually, did not imagine the scenery to be like this. I'm telling you the God's honest truth now. I really didn't know it was going to be this epic here. Like, I'm really shocked actually. This whole journey has just been like view after view after view, especially on the west side of Scotland. I mean, both sides have been amazing, but the east side, the west side. I get so mixed up.
Northwest.
The west side, is
yeah,
it?
Northwest so far, we've done.
Yeah, the northwest side has just been absolutely, like, mind-blowingly stunning. So it's really difficult to move on. We just want to stop everywhere and just have a picnic or have a cup of tea or have a coffee. But there's so much to see that we just have to just keep moving. So, yeah, onwards and upwards.
But it's roads like this that make it, isn't it? These are this is the road that makes the journey. Single track road, middle of nowhere, in the most stunning scenery. It's a proper road trip. Ooh. Ooh. Hey,
oh my God. You're enjoying this too much.
I'm really enjoying this. How nice is that?
Wow.
So pretty.
It's so pretty.
And look, there's snow on that mountain.
So we're going to go in now and see what the menu is. Hopefully, we have no idea what the food is, so hopefully they've got vegan food.
So we are in this pub now, and it looks like the sort of pub that just really wouldn't have any vegan food at all. But we've just looked at the menu and we are so surprised.
So one falafel burger with the vegan cheese and the black bean jambalaya.
So he's going to double check that they are vegan. They look vegan.
One's got vegan cheese, mate.
One's actually got vegan cheese, which is so unexpected. It really is. I was walking into this pub thinking, oh God, maybe we're just gonna have to get some chips or something, but it's really surprising. How amazing does this falafel burger look?
Thank you.
I'll
get
you your vinegar as well.
Cheers.
A couple of sachets,
lovely,
that, yeah, thank you.
I'm going in. That's really good.
No, it's one little bit of kit. Now stop blowing at battery charges, you. So, we just went to the Argyll Hotel pub, so that's what they are out here. And we just had a couple of pints and really nice food. And we're going to go and sleep in their car park tonight. Not the nicest of locations, but it's still, you know, it's a freebie. If we had some refreshments, we didn't have to get the food even. In fact, we didn't even have to go in there, to be fair. We could have just stayed in the car park. But it's just a park up. It's just an overnight thing. This is on our doorstep, this beautiful thing. We're going to go to bed now. I've just been driving so much. It's really tiresome driving as well. It's really, you've got to concentrate because it's so windy and quite dangerous as well, but brilliant at the same time. Very thrilling. So now we're going to go sleep and wake up tomorrow morning, and we've got the next chapter of the adventure tomorrow. We're heading into the big mountain territory tomorrow, so that's going to be awesome.
I was never the one to write up a song for just anyone. I was always the one to find myself lost in long conversations, oh, 'cause I've always been told that things will unfold if you keep on waiting. But then you came along and proved me all wrong. I was so mistaken. 'Cause you glue all the pieces back together. Yeah, you take all my wrongs and make them better. Yeah, you're making me